In the last video, we have seen that how to implement, how are we going to implement this behavior object in our application. So in this video, we are going to integrate a behavior object in our application. So behavior object is nothing but it's like a centralized event where we can able to subscribe our events from one place to all over the application. It's like an event emitter where we can able to get everything from one place, and it will be emitted to all over the application. So these are the things we are going to see this in the application. So for first thing is we need to create a service to our application. So these are the steps to create a service. So first thing, we need to create a service. So in this service class, publicly has to be behavior object, public data type, public behavior object. So the reason of this, the reason for using the public here is then only we can able to access from anywhere. So that is the reason it has to be public, and we need to in the service class, and we need to publish the events. So these are the first thing in a service class. And also the subscribe classes, actually in the subscriber, in whichever subscribe, so wherever we want to subscribe this above events, so in the constructor we need to subscribe this event. The reason of having the subscript constructor is nothing but automatically this will be called while initializing the component. So there is a reason we need to subscribe the service event, that means this behavior object event inside the constructor. Okay, so these are the things we are going to do here. So first thing is we need to create a service. So the command for creating service is ng service folder slash card service. So these are the command I need to get. Yeah, the service folder has been created along with the this card service.js. I hope so, but I will look it in the folder. Service has been created, card service.3.3 is created. Let me go, yes, services have been created. Yes. So what we are going to do is, so first of all we are going to, as I told, first we are going to create a card service behavioral object. So first thing, it has to be public. So as I told here, public has to be behavioral object. So I am just creating public as a behavioral object. I will import this, the necessary dependencies I am just importing here, and apart from this I need to create an event. So this will be subscribed. So the reason why we are using this card service event is nothing but whenever we are doing add to cart event, this function will be called. That means whenever user is doing any action regarding add cart or update cart, this behavioral object function will be, the above function will be called, and it will be updated to everywhere. Okay, so the thing it is, first we need to work for add to cart function. This add to cart function only first we need to work it out, then only we have to work on update cart. So whenever the user is calling this add to cart function, this behavior object will be called, automatically this event will be sent to the all over the application. Okay, so what I am going to do is, I am going to create a function which is specifically used for add to cart. So in previous video itself, Spring Boot itself, we have created a API for add to cart function. So here is the add to cart. So this is the request. So I am just creating a function called add cart. Okay, so we need to call the HTTP API. So for that, I will just import the necessary dependencies. So HTTP service, I hope this service will be inside here. So it has to be something like one step back. Yes, it's working fine. And we need to create an object here. HTTP. So I have created object for this thing, and so it has to be something like variable request. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just call a this dot HTTP post request with token. It's not coming. So if it is any error, it will be shown here, otherwise it won't be shown here. I hope this is working fine. Yes, here is the error. To be any. Okay, so this thing has been done. So the URL, endpoint URL is nothing but we have in our here we have mentioned here. So not sorry, here actually add to cart, right? Yes, add to cart. So what I'm going to do is I'm just simply saying if it is any error, I'm just showing the error. Error in dot API. So here is object. Object ID. So here is nothing but so this will be automatically added in the request in the HTTP API. So I don't want to add that. So here. Object dot quantity. So here object dot price. Okay, so I hope this thing has been added. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna call this function from everywhere. That means initially I will call this function from this add to cart function. So that means from the UI, as you can see. So whenever the user is clicking this add to cart button, I will call this cart service this add to cart. From this app.component component, so I'm gonna create a function is called add to cart. So So here I will import the cart service here. So import cart service. So I will this has to be comes under below the constructor. Add cart. I will create the object for this cart service. So private. I'm running this dot cart service dot add cart function. So here I need to cart object. I will create one variable cart cart objects is equal to. So here what are the parameters I need to pass? I think these are the things I need to pass from here. So that means product ID, quantity, price. So in add to cart I need to pass all the things. So before that we need to go to the UI part, then only I can able to get this. Okay, so in this click, so I need to call this function add cart data. So data dot price, data dot quantity, and then data dot product ID, I think so, correct. I don't know what is the response here, so I need to get the products category. Yeah, we'll get it. Okay, so ID. So this ID I need to pass here. Data.id. Okay, so this ID is data.id. Now the error is coming. Okay. Cart road use product objects. Dot quantity dot price okay, this has been done successfully. Yes, and also if the project is, that means if it is any error, automatically it will be shown there. So I don't want to create anything. So here we need to check one more thing. That means if it is already added, I don't know how the error will be. I think, I hope the error will be coming here. So I error caught in API. So maybe like error dot message. I don't know. Maybe something like I was looked somewhere. So I got error message. I don't know. That means this is specifically for if the product is already in cart. So this will be called. Okay, so as far as I know, this has been done. Okay, everything is has done. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna subscribe this event in my app.component. So before that, what I'm gonna do is one thing. So this is our HTML, right? So as people can, so whenever I am clicking this, I will open the raw HTML. I I don't know where I have kept it, because now I want to explain simple thing in this. Yes, here. So this is a simple HTML which we are using in our application. So for this application, so the thing it is, now we are working only on this page, but if you are going like here, it will be shown something different. But the one thing is, only this thing is like same and same, the top header portion is same in all over the application. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create a simple component where it will be, where we can use this comp in this header section in all over the application. So instead of just copying the same HTML in every page, I'm just creating a component, and I will put the component in all the pages wherever it needed. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create one component, component which is nothing but header component. So I'm just enter, it will be created automatically. Yes, created. So as you can see, it's created. So this portion, only this portion, till the menu, maybe till the menu, maybe or up to like maybe somewhere, because yeah, till the menu, only up to the menu only it has been in the same context. So till the mail is, this thing is there now, I'm gonna copy it everything and make it as a header component. So in the app component HTML, I'm gonna copy everything. Still the mail is, right? Yes, where is the mail is? So I hope it will be, so this thing has to be done. I don't know where the menu is. Mail is, my god, about us is there. Oh shit man, sorry, we are working on this page now. Shit man, okay, sorry, excuse me guys, little bit awkward. Okay, so app dot component. So logbook. Yes, till that it has to be till 194 from, I hope from here, maybe something like from 5th to end navigation. So I hope, yes, I will copy everything and I will make it as a header component. Where is header? I will change this header component. So what I am gonna do is, I am just copy this app header and I will paste it in a app.component.html. So the reason is, wherever I want, I can able to use this header instead of copying and pasting everything. I'm just copying and I will check whether it's working or not. It's refreshing. Yes, it's working fine, there won't be any issue. So this is the one thing in Angular application here. I don't know, this thing is not working. I don't know, it's login functionalities. This thing is not working because the reason is, we have done some changes, some this thing is login or something is not available here. So this thing, current drop down menu is open login dialog. So this thing we have to move from here to header.ts. Okay, and also the login functionalities we have to move from app.component to header component. So yes, so this thing is, we need to work it on that. We just copied everything regarding the constructor. Maybe we can change here. So we don't want card service here. Maybe no, we need here. So we need to import the, both the HTTP service and the card service. So it has to be one step back. And then this dot welcome username. So welcome username is on here. So we don't want this category list because it will be done in this page. I don't want that. So this thing has to be needed. So apart from this, do I need anything? So here this code won't be available because now we move this thing in the web pages. So I took out this needed categories, logout, login. Yes, logout is needed. Yes, logout is moved here, and the login user check also needed because now we moved this here. Not only login, we need a register also. So actually guys, this is one of the best advantage using this Angular framework. The thing it is, we can able to create as number of any components, and we can able to integrate with all our application without spending too much time. So header component expected line number 86. Sometimes error also coming. We need to work it out. Yes, the variable is missing. So just copied everything. Once again guys, I will include everything. Yes, just open dialog, I don't know why it's error. Somewhere I have done some mistake. While copying, yes, just saving everything, going this function. I hope, yeah, it's working fine. I never expected. So as you guys, actually, I want to tell one thing. So by default, this first product will be loaded. The code I have done is here. So in the app.component, I am just loading the category. I am just loading all the category. So in this category, if the category is not empty, that means if the length is greater than one, I am just getting the product from the data of zero. So here, so it should not be like categories. It should be like get product by category. So also in the app constructor also I need to change. So get products by category. So this category ID, request, subscribe, product list length, alert from product form, the product by category, the data of zero. So this data of zero, nothing but first category. So whatever the category is available from the database, if the length is greater than one, I am just passing this category from the zeroth array to the get product category object. So object.id, which is nothing but the passing parameter. This object will have this key of id, so I'm just passing this id here, and as usual the same thing will happen. The same thing I'm just calling from this function also. So whenever I'm picking the category, that means from here it will be passed along with the id, to this function. So as usual, the same function, this function. So this function, the parameter is object, which will have this ID. As usual, you people know the apart from and then the consequences, the product list will be loaded from the response. Then looping will be done. So okay. So I hope you people understand. So the reason why I have done this header changes is nothing but, so whenever user is clicking this add to cart, I need to done some changes here. So I want to show the counter something like that. Here I have done some UI changes, but it has to be something like it has to come along with this add to cart button. So I will show the product count here. So this has to be like equation fixed, right? So inside that, this content has to come here. So I put here. Yes. So what I have done is, I'm gonna show the add to cart count here. So whenever I'm clicking, it will navigate to the checkout cart button, or maybe it will show the pop-up. So I'm just changing the color into white. Right now. So I will change some. I will give some padding because now I'm just adding. Maybe height I will increase to 50. Yes, correct. It's working right. So total count is 20. So I have to change that. So style.css 179. I have changed the style. CSS. View cart, it has to be 50, and the color in the, I don't know where I have done the changes for this color, style.css. Plus the total checkout cart 167. So I will change into something different. So I will change this header also. So I will put this thing I have created my own, so I will just put it in the top. So I will put here. Yes, it came here. So this quantity has to be changed from our cart service. So here I'm just creating one variable cart, something like quantity. So just copied everything, just copy the variable, and I will create a variable here. Initially it will be zero. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna create a service inside the constructor. Dot cart service dot cart service event dot subscribe. So here is all the things will come here, because here only we need to subscribe all the events. So once again guys, I will subscribe, I don't know, subscribe. So here, one second. Share in the subscribe, data will come. So here, the data will be received, which we are sending from the service. So what I'm gonna do is, here I'm gonna update this dot cart quantity is equal to the quantity which I'm going to access from the service cart service, that get quantity. So this method we need to create. Okay, so only this method we need to create in the cart service. So I'm going to create one method called point quantity. So this method is written this dot quantity. So we need to create a cart total item, maybe something like, we need to create a variable here which is nothing but what quantity. So initially it has to be zero. Okay, so next thing is cart object, so which will have everything. So this functionalities we need to have, we need to fetch our APIs. So we have done the APIs already. So written this quantity. So here the APIs add to cart is there, add to cart already we have done. So check out cart, maybe get cart by user. So this is the method where we need to enter with our cart API, which will give all the details regarding the cart application. So here, as soon as you can in the constructor itself, we need to call this function, this dot, maybe instead of this thing, it has to be some centralized method, then only we can call from everywhere. So get cart details by user, this dot http dot get post request with token. So this has to be something like, and the parameter will be, I hope only the get cards by user ID. I don't know why it's needed, we have to check. I think only user ID is enough, correct? Oops, I will log in here. I will pass the token because the token has been expired. So we'll pass the token. Guys, maybe the people who started watching here, these things have been already expired. Yes, only the user ID is enough. So I think we don't want to send anything here. So guys, actually the thing, it is the Spring framework, all the details has been done in the previous video. So if you have not watched any videos regarding this Java Spring Boot application, you can watch from the part 1 to part 10. So there we were doing all the API changes. Okay, so here now we will come to the Angular part. So here we don't want to send anything. I just subscribe data. If it is any error, so I will show the error. Error while fetching the cart details. So it has to be something like array of data, right? Yes, it's array of data. So what I'm going to do is cart object, this dot cart object is equal to data. So again it will be like any so the same thing, cart quantity is equal to data dot length in GTH data dot length. So from here I am gonna update the event. That means this dot cart service event dot, next. So this is the very important thing in our service. That means from here only we are going to send the events to all over the application. So this is a very important concept in our application. So yes, next completed. So here I'm gonna send one status, nothing but status. So this is for just like simple status purposes. If need, we can use that. Otherwise, we don't want that. So completed. Okay. So whenever this method has been called, whenever the service response is successfully, automatically this event will be triggered. This means here the emitter will be thrown to all over the application. So the component which are the components which will ready for the subscribing this event, automatically they will receive the notification. So for example, so here yes, so the subscribe will be triggered only when this will be emitted. Okay, so when this will be emitted, this thing has to be loaded in the variable. So this quantity will be applied here. So these are the things. I hope you people understand. If you can't understand, I'm just repeating again. So we will create a one. So these are the steps we have done here. We will create one header component in this video. So in this header component, we have subscribe for the event. For the event, and we created a service. This service will have a behavioral object. As we have seen, this service will have one behavioral object. This behavior object is will be triggered one way, that means will be triggered or will emit the event only when the service has been completed. That means when the event is completed, the behavior object will be triggered only when any cart actions as performed. Okay, so trigger will be behavior will be triggered only when cart actions is performed. So the same thing, so whenever so the next step is whenever it will trigger the service subscribed components will get notified from the above behavior object, that means above event, and they will call the and it will call the service. That means if any actions done by user regarding the cart actions, this trigger event will be performed. That means when the trigger event performed, the subscribed components, the component which are subscribed for the events, will get notified. That means when this has been notified, this means this will be notified. So the functions, the codes which is inside this thing will be automatically triggered. So this thing is automatically, this cart service will be called, this get quantity. So this quantity will be called, so automatically this thing will be refreshed. Okay, so now we will run our application. I hope everything will be done. Yes, as you can see, if it is zero, I didn't do anything. So if I am click anything here, add to cart and pay refund, I don't know what's the error. User ID is missing. Yeah, everything has gone. I don't know why user ID is missing. How come? In the HTTP service, post stroke. Oh, here is a problem. We didn't store this user ID token, is login token, set login token, man. Okay, we need to add this. So now we can have a static ID just for just showing what is that. Sorry, I will change this into dynamically based on the. So now I am showing as an one. I hope so. So I am just clicking. Oh my god. Why? quantity is missing. Right. Okay. Cart service quantity is there. Maybe I'm not sending from app.component. Here also I'm sending. I don't know, cart product object. Maybe I need to check it out. Cart object. I will debug now here actually, then only we can able to understand source. So control P is a shortcut method, we can able to get the TS file. So I will just put a debugger here. So I'm just clicking add to cart. Yes, undefined. Oh man. Okay. Yeah, initially the quantity will be given by the user, right? Yes, I didn't understand. Okay, no problem. Okay. So initially add to cart will be, the quantity will be 1. So here it will be 1. Okay. This has to be given by the user. Yeah. Okay, so I'm just clicking here. Something has done. I don't know, but nothing has been changed. Just refreshing here. Nothing has done. Maybe I will change. I will check the database if it is any add to cart is done performed here. Yes, it has been done here. Request has been done, but I don't know, nothing changes. Add to cart, service add to cart. I hope everything has done. Add to cart. Oh man, I didn't do the changes. I need to call this thing here. It's got to go. Okay, I will delete this record because it will give the error. So I'll delete the record in the database. So I'll just refresh. I'm just clicking. Error, some error, I don't know. Snet is not a function. Where? Cart services. I don't know, guys. I will check it out. I found the error actually. So here, instead of cart object, so I have used cart service event. So that's the reason this event has been overwritten within data. So this method is not available. So the thing is, I'm just refreshing everything. I'm just delete the data from the database. I have to. So as usual, I'm just giving add to cart. Yes, have you done the change? It changes to the 1. So our API is successfully working. So now you can see it is 1. So if I'm clicking here, it will be changed as 2. Yeah, it's working fine. So if we come to the database actually, so this will be changed. Yes, it's working fine. So our add to cart API has been successfully completed. So as we have seen, so now I am giving the request from app.component. This request will be sent to the cart service. Once the request and everything is completed from my API, I'm just calling this function. This means this function is nothing but getting the cart details by user ID. So this has been sent to the user, and once the request is completed, I'm just sending to all the components whoever subscribe this event next completed. So once this is completed, this will be sent to here, this component, header component. Maybe if I want to subscribe to one number of components, I can able to do that. So here only the header component is subscribing this event. So once this event is coming here, I am just getting the quantity from my cart service. So here I am just having the quantity. So whenever I am just giving this add to cart, automatically this will be sent to the cart service. This cart service, once the add to cart is completed, it will call the update. It will call the get cart details by user. So this function will be called, and once the response is coming, it will be called. It will be triggered to header component. The header component will get all the details of the details. That's it. Okay, so this is our add to cart API. Add to cart API has been completed, successfully integrated with our application. So in the next tutorial, I think we have seen how can we show the single product. Single product details in single one page, and along with add cards. Apart from this, image shown to the products, and then last thing is checkout API. So I hope this checkout API will be a priority than the images, correct? So these are the things we have to show, and also with API with HTML design, right? So we don't have any checkout page, so we need to have the checkout HTML design. So these are the things we are going to see in the next video. So thank you guys. Please subscribe and share with your friends. If you have any doubts, please comment it. Definitely I will share the source code as soon as possible in the description below via GitHub repository. Thank you. Thank you, Ondra. Please subscribe.